Good morning, and welcome to St. Ignatius Parish here in Winnipeg. And this morning we gather to give thanks to God for a wonderful woman, Eunice Sinnott, and we also gather to pray that she will be with God today. And we're gathered in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. And the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of the Father, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with all of you. On the day of her baptism, Eunice was welcomed into the church, given new life in Christ, and clothed with the garment of salvation. Today we greet her body, the body of our sister, and surround her with the church's prayer. We commend our sister Eunice to the mercy of God, and pray that the promise made to her in baptism will be fulfilled. Please join in the opening song.
Sing. void of snow and rain. I have borne my people's pain. I have wept for love of them. They turn away. I will break their hearts of stone, give them hearts for love alone. I will speak.
Welcome, everyone, and all of you join me in offering condolences to Eunice's family, well-loved woman and her family, but also in the parish. And I invite everyone to please sit down, and I invite Dave to come forward to give us some words about Eunice.
Anne, Michelle, and I thank you for attending the funeral of our mother. Mom would also state this should be a celebration as well, and that she is now happily in the presence of our Creator. Our mother was an exceptional woman in many respects. Eunice was a great mother, an inspiring mentor, and an exemplar in her compassion and love. Her charisma, her patience and her care for others won her many good friends in her life. She truly treasured her friendships. Mom was driven by her love for Jesus and readily shared her belief in the redemptive power of Christ's sacrifice, even to her last day on earth. Eunice's life was always filled with worthwhile endeavors. Not only did she conceive of the idea for her family to immigrate to Canada, but acted upon it and began her family's adventures in Canada. In her inimitable organized fashion, she arranged for her dad, Jim, to come several months before us to establish a home base in Winnipeg. Then, under her guidance, we embarked on the journey from Dublin to Liverpool, where we boarded the ship, the Sylvania, to across the Atlantic to Montreal. With three kids, 14 pieces of luggage, and $75. She caught the CP passenger train to Winnipeg. At every station stop, we expected our dad to be there. When we got to Winnipeg, Jim was not at the CP station yet because he was at the wrong station, the CN station. Of course, Mum was unperturbed. Upon arriving in 1958, once her family was settled, she set off to work to ensure that we were housed and well fed. She went on to a long, successful career in business management at a time when women were just beginning to enter careers in business. Eunice was an avid artist and produced many wonderful oil paintings, which are now sprinkled in homes in eastern Canada, from the prairies to the west coast. Late in 1958, our parents fortuitously met Mike and Ines Nikolsky, our aunt and uncle. Mum's friendship with Ina and their many travels and adventures together were driven by a deep sisterly love for each other. They had each other to share life's many challenges when their husbands passed away earlier in their lives. Our mom's greatest gift was her love for her children, her grandchildren, her great-grandchildren, and her great-great-grandchild, the newest and most recent addition, Haven. I won't name them all, it's a large, evolving group. But I would be remiss if I did not mention her love and trust for Michelle's husband, Dave, who along with Michelle looked after Mom on her long and difficult final journey. Eunice counseled with great insight into life and generally proposed a solid plan, a solid action plan to resolve any problems, which of course was monitored by her for success. Three aspects stand out: a wonderful sense of humor, constant encouragement, and despair was simply not in her vocabulary. It was not allowed. She chose to emphasize the resilience of the human spirit in adverse conditions, or if you prefer, pull up your knickers and carry on. I think it's fair to say that her three children, Anne, Michelle, and I, inherited her sense of humor at least to some extent. And indeed, it appears to have passed down to subsequent generations, and there's certainly no lack of aspiring comedians in the whole horde. Mom's curiosity, intelligence, and desire to meet her birth family led her on a search with her genealogy partner, her daughter-in-law, Angela, and to her great and abiding joy, she was able to establish friendship with her two half-sisters, Jean and Jillian, who emigrated from England as well. Coincidentally, to land in Ontario. That friendship was cherished by Eunice. In our ever-changing world, Mum was our bulwark. We will remember and miss her always. We will try to emulate her example and carry the torch she has passed to us. She would want it that way. And she would also say, Jesus loves you, and don't forget to pray. A reading from the letter of Paul to the Romans. Do you not know that all of us who have been baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death? Therefore, we have been buried with him by baptism into death, so that just as Christ was raised from the dead in the glory of the Father, or by the glory of the Father, so we too might walk in newness of life. For if we have been united with him in a death like his, we will certainly be united with him in a resurrection like his. We know that our old self was crucified with him so that the body of sin might be destroyed and we might no longer be enslaved to sin. For whoever has died is freed from sin. But if we have died with Christ, we believe that we will also live with him. We know that Christ, being raised from the dead, will never die again. Death no longer has dominion over him. The word of the Lord.
Thank you, Dave. Please stand. We begin our liturgy always by remembering who we are before God, and that is we are sinners. And during this Easter time, we remember particularly that Jesus came because we are sinners, and we need only turn and ask, and that mercy is there. You raise the dead to life in the Spirit, Lord, have mercy. You bring pardon and peace to the sinner, Christ, have mercy. You bring light to those in darkness, Lord, have mercy. And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. And let us bow our heads in prayer. O Lord, listen kindly to our prayers as our faith in your Son raised from the dead is deepened. May our hope of resurrection for your departed servant Eunice also find new strength. Grant this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen. And please be seated, and now we'll have the psalm response. Jason, I now invite Michelle to come up to read our second reading.
Good A reading from the letter, the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Love will never pass away. Strive for the greater gifts, and I will show you a still more excellent way. If I speak in the tongues of mortals and of angels, but do not have love, I am a noisy gong or a clanging cymbal. And if I have prophetic powers and understand all mysteries and all knowledge, and if I have all faith so as to remove mountains, but I do not have love, I have nothing. If I give away all my possessions, and if I hand over my body so that I may boast, but do not have love, I gain nothing. Love is patient. Love is kind. Love is not envious or boastful or arrogant or rude. It does not insist on its own way. It is not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice in wrongdoing, but rejoices in the truth. It bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, and endures all things. Love never ends. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Thank you, Michelle. When Jesus saw the crowds, he went up the mountain, and after he sat down, his disciples came to him. Then he began to speak and taught them, saying, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. And blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the earth. And blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be filled. And blessed are the merciful, for they will receive mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they will see God. And blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. And blessed are those who are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. And blessed are you when people revile you and persecute you and utter all kinds of evil against you falsely on my account. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward is great in heaven, for in the same way they persecuted the prophets who were before you." The Gospel of the Lord. By the words of the Holy Gospel, may our sins be taken away. Father Newman would always explain that when we come to celebrate a funeral or to do a funeral, to grieve at a funeral, we begin by remembering the person's earthly life. And thank you, Dave, for coming and give us those words to recall Eunice's earthly life. But then as we move on into the Eucharist, we begin to remember and recall the new life that the person who has died has begun to live. And that's what we do today. And thank you, Dave, for those wonderful words. It is my privilege to know Eunice, but particularly to have that one last visit last week at Michelle and David's home. We prayed together and chatted together, and we celebrated the sacrament of the anointing of the sick. Eunice was at peace throughout, and especially as she received the Eucharist, it ended up being viaticum, the food for the journey, food for the way, viaticum. You know, all the readings for Eunice's funeral today were chosen by her, and it's wonderful she's teaching us even after she's gone. Her concern is to teach us. And they all point to her faith. In the first reading, St. Paul tells us in the Romans that in our baptism, we promise to strive always to turn away from our selfishness and sin and try to live the new life Jesus offers us in his resurrection. And it's nice kind of we're doing this during Easter time. We have the font here from the vigil night, the bubbling water, and we have the Christ candle there burning brightly. In our baptism, Jesus promises that if we share in his suffering and death, we will also share in the fullness of his resurrection. And that promised life, that promised new life, already begins to happen even at the moment of our baptism. During the Easter Vigil and through this Easter time, particularly that first week, how often the readings and the prayers were recalling our baptism, how we were baptized. In the second reading, St. Paul tells the Corinthians and us how to live the resurrected life we began to live at our baptism. The key is to love like Jesus loved and loves. And St. Paul describes in some detail what loving means, what loving is. And it's a passage we often hear at weddings as the couple make their covenant with one another before God. And of course it's appropriate. It's appropriate because they are setting out to be a sign to us of God's love for us, his people, and how we are to love. It's a beautiful passage and one most of us are very familiar with, and thank you, Michelle, for reading it so well. It was beautiful. And in the Gospel reading, we hear in other great detail how we are to be like Jesus, how we are to love. It kind of expands on the Paul's letter to the Corinthians. Jesus, prefigured by Moses centuries before, went up the mountain to teach his disciples how to enter the heavenly kingdom. He gives his 10-word description of that kind of person. And he mentions, blessed are the poor in heart, blessed are those who mourn, blessed are those who are meek, blessed who are merciful, pure in heart, peacemakers. He describes how we are to get to that heavenly kingdom. At another time, Jesus was asked to summarize all that. And he was asked, what is the greatest commandment? And he keeps on telling us what we've heard again and again in all these other passages we just referred to. And he says, he quotes, as a matter of fact, from the Hebrew Bible, you shall love the Lord your God with your whole mind, soul, and strength. And then he added the essential second commandment, you shall love your neighbor as yourself. Well, it's clear, Eunice choosing these passages, that she knew all this. And she knew that the center of our faith is in Jesus' promise that those who follow his path will share in the marvel of his resurrection. And as the preface for today's Mass declares, for those who believe and follow him when they die, life is changed, not ended. With the risen Jesus, they will not die again. There will be no tears, no mourning. Their thirst will be completely assuaged with the water from life. Jesus made that promise to Eunice at her baptism, and she took Jesus at his word. And today we celebrate her completion of her baptismal promises and trust that Jesus will be true to his. Then what about us? What about us who come to grieve and pray? We still have to complete our promises. Let us be inspired by Eunice's life and be spurred on to live our baptismal promises keenly, striving always to say yes to God and no to selfishness and sin. Today we celebrate Eunice's birth into eternity, and we trust that she is with our loving God and will be there to welcome each one of us when we are called, and that's bound to happen, eh? Let us live our lives in such a way that at the end of time, we will be with Eunice again, and together, we will see our loving God face to face. I invite Dave Carr to come forward to lead us in our prayer petitions. Please stand. And brothers and sisters, Jesus is risen from the dead and sits at the right hand of the Father, where he intercedes for us, his church. Confident that God hears the voices of those who trust in the Lord Jesus, we join our prayers to his. And the response to each petition is, Lord, hear our prayer.
Jesus died for us. May he share with us his risen life. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For the church, may it grow in faith in Jesus' power over death. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For Eunice, that as she brought us unity and love, may she now receive the reward of the blessed. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For all the deceased friends and relatives of Eunice, may they see God's face in his glory. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. Father of mercy and forgiveness, may you strengthen us through the mystery of your son's death on the cross and fill us with hope by the glorious sign of resurrection. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. Father of mercy and forgiveness, free Eunice from the power of death and welcome her to the assembly of your saints. We pray for the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. We pray the Hail Mary together. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. And blessed is the Lord, the Lord Jesus. Hail Mary, Mother of God, blessed are the sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. May the Lord
keep us in his love and lead us to eternal life. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. Please be seated for the offertory. Friends, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Father Almighty. O Lord, look favorably on our offerings, so that your departed servant Eunice may be taken up into glory with your Son, in whose great mystery of love we are all united. Grant this through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
And let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him, the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of death might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord.
Lord, you are indeed holy, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith
we proclaim. Your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with this Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. And may he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, Saint Ignatius of Loyola, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help.
May our sacrifice, may this sacrifice of a reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Richard, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy and religious, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember your servant Eunice, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she, who was united with your Son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up in the flesh those who have died and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters too, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages and praise you without end, through Christ our Lord, through whom we bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen, 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 amen.
When we were baptized, we became children of God. Jesus taught us a prayer to keep reminding us of that, and so now let us pray that prayer together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we wait the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. We pause for a moment now to ask God for that gift of peace, peace for our world, peace for our communities, peace for our families, peace in our hearts. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. And may the peace of our Lord Jesus be with you always. And turning to those nearby, let us offer a sign that we are indeed God's family. Peace. Peace, peace, peace. And peace to those who are joining us from home. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world, and blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I'm not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. May the body and blood of our Jesus bring us to everlasting life. Amen. There will be two stations for communion at the top of the center aisle here, one on each side of the casket, right at the front. So we'll come up the center aisle and return to the, through the side aisles. And for those who are not receiving communion, you please come up for a blessing and indicate that you want a blessing just by putting your hands like that. Okay? Thank you.
Thank you.
Let us pray. O Lord, grant, we pray, that your servant Eunice, for whom we have celebrated this Paschal sacrament, may pass over to a dwelling place of light and peace. Grant this through Christ our Lord. We come now to the part of our celebration which is called the final commendation. After this prayers and dismissal, the family invites everyone to come downstairs for a celebration of, I think we'll have, there's some, a slide presentation there of Eunice's life that Charlie put together for you to view, and also a time to come and share your thoughts and prayers and the love of Eunice with one another. So before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our sister, and may our farewell express our affection for her. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. And one day we shall joyfully greet her again, when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. In baptism, as we've mentioned many times already today, Eunice shared in the death and resurrection of Christ. And may she be welcomed now into the glory of eternal life. And what I'll do now is I will sprinkle water from our font here that we blessed at the Easter Vigil to remind us and remember Eunice's baptism and also our own baptisms. Incense always is a sign of our prayers rising up to God. And so, as a sign of respect for our sister Eunice, we will let incense rise to God, who has called her to share in his glory.
Songs of the angels welcome you and guide you along your way. May the smiles of the martyrs greet your own as darkness turns into day. Every fear will be undone. And and death will be no more. As songs of the angels bring you home before the face of God.
Into your hands, Father of Mercies, we commend our sister Eunice in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, she will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you have bestowed upon Eunice in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you and our sister forever. Amen. After the reception downstairs, we'll be going to the cemetery at Glen Lawn. Chapel Lawn, which is in the west part of the city, just beyond the perimeter. So those who wish are invited to come to the interment also after the reception. So dear friends, may every mark of affection and every gesture of friendship you give to others be a sign of God's peace for you. And in peace we take our sister to her place of rest. Go in the peace of Christ, alleluia, alleluia.
Thanks be to God, alleluia, alleluia.
Bled and died.
take away my sin. Then sings my soul, my Savior God to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior. Joy shall fill my heart. Then I shall bow in humble adoration, and there proclaim, my God, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul.